Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm very happy to see you. And thank you for your great recording. It was so impressive. Every piece was so impressive for me. Especially I was moved by your Coltrane.
Oh, small excerpt that I did.
Yeah, so cool. I want to hear the whole piece, yeah. So, for today, I chose Brahms Sonata. It was so good. I can say just a few minor things to suggest you. Can we try from the beginning? Thank you. From here. Thank you. It's great. So it's so passionate and really brilliant sound. I love your brilliant sound. It's really great. And how do you think about this? Here it's written poco forte. What do you think about this poco forte? It's how it's not forte, but poco forte means.
I know poco, just the word poco. It means little, right? A little forte?
Yeah, a little forte.
That's the actual term, what it means.
So for my opinion, it's simply just like a mezzo forte. So not with a full tension, but a little bit calm. But you played enough representative, so it's very good. So a little bit calm, can you start with, and the technical things or the practical things should be you the high note. This high note, can you stay a little bit longer on this high note? It makes the audience to be comfortable a little bit, I think. Yeah.
So like hold it out a little longer.
So you should be a little bit calm on the high notes, a little bit longer. You don't have to be hurried to go through the high note. So please give me some more little time to stay on the high note. Still here again. So yeah, great. It's very good, I think. So and the bar 12, the little conclusion of the sentence. So you must be more resolutely. And this quarter note should be, what can I say? A little bit with the weight. Could you please from the beginning? Yeah, great. Yeah, it's very nice this. Yeah, I love it. So the next comes till here. You said that what you introducing yourself or introducing what Brahms think about for beginning of the sonata. And then comes the following sentences. It explains a little more clearly and that sorry. okay, can you continue? What?
Substance.
Yeah. Thank you, Rudolf. It comes the substances, so you can more clearly speak. Yeah, I mean, you did it, but would you please let me hear the following?
So go from that forte on the second line?
Yeah. Much is great. Minor things, but I prefer the last quarter note every time. I should be a little longer to sustain the note. I mean, okay. For example, the bar 7th. It's okay. Can you try from the 26th?
Like I said, I don't have measure numbers, so I don't know where bar 26 is.
From
yeah.
This last quarter note.
So have that on the longer side.
A little bit. To the end, a little bit sustained. Not throw up the ball and a little bit strain, a little bit stay on the ball, stay on the string, your ball. Yeah. I prefer that.
Okay.
It's okay for you. It's also comfortable for you.
Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah, thank you. So it's great. And the next part. Please,
the next
from part. From the gentle part.
Oh, from there, okay.
Yeah. For this part, yeah, you're really great. And here comes the second time you played and next it's written with some crescendos, right?
Yeah.
So you can play the difference more clearly. So with the second times with the crescendo and to make the sentence you can make the line. Yeah. Would you please? So thank you. I think, okay, the second time. This note should be a little bit longer to make the crescendo more easily, efficiently. Can you play this quarter? I mean the bass is not too much short. So, you can take time. No. I mean the second note B. You can take time on B. So
I can take time on which note?
On B. Yeah, B. B. B flat.
Oh, the B flat.
Oh, sorry, B flat. Okay, thank you. I mean the second B. Okay. You can take enough time to express the crescendo. It's a little bit. It looks like a little bit shy to make the crescendo. So can you do to make a little bit longer? The B flat.
So on the second
yeah.
grouping, you want that second B flat to be longer to make the crescendo
right.
round out the line more. That's what you're saying?
Yeah, right. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, please continue the next section. Here, the 16th passages are very clearly and it's so good, and I want to only say that the first motif where will be the heaviest in this five notes. Which is the heaviest, most heavy, you think? How do you think of?
Maybe the last note.
Last note? Oh, that could be. Yeah.
Because I know that for these first four bars in this Ben Marcato section, the piano and the viola are passing it off.
Mm-hmm.
With the same exact type of rhythmic figure. So maybe that?
Are you mean the first bar? No, in this five notes, which is the most heavy? You think the last one?
Or you know what, maybe the third note?
So you think so, yeah.
Because it's da 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 da
da da. Yeah.
The phrasing.
Yeah, that's good thing. Yeah. Phrasing, yeah. But for my opinion, it comes the first note is heavier, the most heaviest. So, and even you think, even it's, it goes. You think your thoughts, the third one is the heavy. It's okay. So if it's heavy, so you can play this note a little bit long enough that is written. For my feeling, a little bit too light. It's a little bit too light.
Too light.
Yeah. I prefer that a little longer.
So I was just moving my music over so I could write in the notes. So it needs to be, yeah, okay. So.
Yeah, I prefer this length of the third note. And don't stop the Rudolph, what did the cling in English?
The sound.
Sound, is it just sound? Yeah. And the sound should be a little, it continues a little bit longer, just a bit, but the third, eighth note. Don't stop the sound.
Don't stop the sound, yeah.
And I prefer the heaviest is the first one. I suppose you can taste this third, eighth note a little bit. You can taste and enjoy the third, eighth note. How about this? Don't be shy at the end of the sentence. Don't be shy. Don't be too shy. You have to. You can play the quarter notes also with the length long enough. You know. This note to the end of the bar. Great.
Keep going.
Let's continue. Yeah. Yeah. Great. Brilliant. Can you take a little black here?
More of the yeah, right?
Before that.
A little break before that.
Little break.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great. It should be good articulated, so it's clear the sentences. So it's very good.
Writing that in, break.
Yeah.
All right, go on.
A little bit break. Yeah, go on. You can take time here also. Don't be hurry here. No, you can take time. Yeah, even more. But it's okay. Yeah.
Even more time.
Yeah, but it's okay. Yeah. You don't have to hurry. Beautiful, yeah, go on. Thank you, thank you. These two sentences, the first phrase is written with piano, and the next comes pianissimo, pianissimo, it's okay. And here again, you can play the last note of the slide two, if there's a slide two notes here. This second note should be a little bit longer for my feeling. Even more. Here also, and the second times also, it makes the phrase clearly, I think. It's not, yeah. Yeah, great. One more thing, would you please change some colors between the piano and pianissimo? You can imagine other color to play the pianissimo, special pianissimo. Thank you so much. And so, this part, here comes, it's written with the
espressivo,
so you can express more, you can play even more impressive. I know you can.
String. Okay, so I'll start from the pianos again, just to...
Yeah, thank you. The second note of the song, a little bit longer to make this line. Change color. Great, it's brilliant, thank you. It's this section you play so excellent. Yeah, I love you, it's very passionate and in the high position, you play so well. I can do that, it's so great. Yeah, would you please hear
keep going.
Yeah, going on. Thank you. Great. Thank you. Here comes the theme again. So it should be more impressive. And when you start with the theme, you have the sports under on in E. You know, it's okay. So the sports under should be a little more strong for my feeling. Can you try that? And you can make the in the theme section after the double bar. Do you have the crescendo and the decrescendo?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can do it. Yeah, more. You can over. Yeah, please overdo that a little bit. About this, from my feeling, the sforzando section is it should be a little with more power or the strength than you played. I mean, the sforzando should be a little bit stronger, but you start with the upbow, right? Because of that, I think it's not strong enough. You don't have to change it to down bow, but even with up bow, can you play a little bit sharp? Thank you. And the very, so it's very the detail, but after the sforzando, you gradually immediate the diminuendo. You can do it. So you should be very very careful. The second D note is without accent is better, and so you can make the decrescendo gradually. Again, the same thing. The last of the last note of the sla is a little bit longer. For example, here. Till the end of the bar, you can take time, a little bit. The quarter notes. It will be easy to keep the bow at the beginning. You don't keep a bow a little bit, and on the third beat, you can take you can use the bow more. So it will work, I think. Shy on the third beat. Yeah, first one was good. The second bar, you should be more powerful. Third beat. Great. Can I go? Thank you. The next section is the same that we did before. So can we skip to the sostenuto and espressivo section, you know? Okay.
Skip the to last, the area.
For my opinion, how do you think about the tempo change in the sostenuto section? I think that sostenuto means sustained. Yeah, sustain the length of each note, but it comes to resultly the tempo slowing, but it's not mean. It doesn't mean that make tempo slowly intentionally. It comes naturally, for my opinion. So don't change tempo too much when it comes to this section. How do you think about that?
Well, the little section before that, the where it crescendos all the way through, that's kind of like the transition almost.
And I think the theme comes again.
Yeah, exactly.
From here you slow down normally. I've so watched your video, so I prefer it shouldn't be too much. It was a little bit too much for me, for my feeling. But can you try from the theme again? Feeling it's too much slow, the sostenuto section. Would you please keep the tempos before a little bit, so not change so much the tempo. The last six was amazing. Yeah, really beautiful. Thank you so much. That's I hope even for just a bit it was informative for you. Then I'd be happy. Yeah, how about, is there any questions?
Not really. I think it was great, really, you know, diving into those details. I loved it.
Oh, thank you. So, I'm very happy to work with you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's wrap up for today. Yeah, but see you. Yeah, I hope I can work with you again.
Of course.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for your time.
Have a nice holidays.
You too. Yeah.